There are many motifs in the films of Quentin Tarantino. Trunk shots, black and white suits, dancing, and food. Yes, food. And while it's common for characters to be eating and drinking in cinema, no one does it quite like Tarantino.
Royale with you.
That's right.
This is Motifs and Motives, Tarantino and Food. Hit subscribe and click the bell to see what our next motif will be. We're going to be spoiling many of Tarantino's films, and graphic content lays ahead. You've been warned.
You know what this is? It's the world's smallest violin playing just for the waitresses.
Most of the time when we see characters eating or drinking, it's just busy work. Something to do while the dialogue carries the scene.
Don't you ever raise your voice at me! I am your mother!
And Tarantino does that as well. But it also goes much deeper than that.
What?
I don't need you to tell me how good my coffee is, okay? I'm the one who buys it. I know how good it is.
There are layers to the ways Tarantino uses food and drink, each one more complex than the last. We'll start with the most basic application of this motif. How eating and drinking inform character.
May I have a glass of water, please?
Like many filmmakers, Tarantino uses food for characterization.
I'm hungry. Let's get a taco.
What a character eats and drinks gives us immediate insight into their personality.
Want some bacon?
No, man, I don't eat pork.
Consider how Cliff eating mac and cheese adds to his character.
Sudden change.
The same for Calvin's sweet tooth.
What'd you dig him up?
Or Melanie eating noodles. Our notion of Bill as the ultimate villain is complicated when we see him lovingly make his daughter a sandwich. Without any dialogue, we understand these characters just a little bit more.
The plot thickens.
How and when they eat and drink gives us even more insight into these characters.
Guy's German here wants to die for country. Oblige him.
The way Aldo casually eats a sandwich during a brutal execution. How Lance dines on cereal in the middle of the night. The sloppy way Bud makes margaritas. All of these contexts build pure characterization. But this is just the beginning.
Here you go. Wrap your lips around that.
Not only do we learn about characters through their food, it is also used to express the character dynamics between them.
Monsieur, votre famille et à vos vaches. Je dis bravo.
I think I just always associated getting to know somebody. It always happens over restaurants and dinners.
Don't you just love it when you come back from the bathroom to find your food waiting for you?
It can facilitate romance.
Would you like to go get some pie with me?
I love some pie.
It could create a bond between strangers.
Oh, yes, a bottle of warm sake, please.
Warm sake? Very good!
It can be used in celebration.
Auf Max! Auf Max!
But more than anything in Tarantino's work, it is used for power and control.
I've always found restaurant scenes to be kind of ritualistic. I have rituals play out, and some of them are the rituals of the balance of power shifting or being established.
I don't tip.
You don't tip?
No, I don't believe in it.
Deux strudel, un pour moi et un pour la demoiselle.
Hans Lander controls Shoshana with a delectable strudel.
Attendez la crème.
Food becomes a reward when a slave pleases his master.
You enjoy that, boy. You've earned it.
Yes, sir.
Or, when obedient dogs are well-trained. Ordell uses the promise of fried chicken to lure Beaumont out of his house.
When we get through with these go rings, me and you go to Roscoe Chicken and Waffle on me.
And to his death.
Okay, we gotta do it.
And of course, when Jules asserts his dominance.
Big Kahuna Burger. That's that Hawaiian burger joint. I hear they got some tasty burgers. I ain't never had one myself. How are they?
Go ahead. You mind if I try one of yours?
In every way, shape, and form, Jules coming in there as this black male, just completely dominating by taking a bite out of the guy's hamburger. He took it from him.
Mm-hmm. This is a tasty burger.
But perhaps the most interesting way Tarantino uses food is to juxtapose it with violence and create tonal shifts.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
If you've seen any of Tarantino's films, you know that they can change tones in an instant. A theological conversation suddenly becomes a gruesome slapstick comedy.
I mean, do you think that God came down from heaven and stopped?
Oh! And these tonal shifts are intentional.
Oh man, I shot Marvin in the face. Did you do that?
Well, I didn't mean to do it. It was an accident.
I like things that can switch tones is being able to turn on a dime. I love getting people to laugh at things that they would never laugh at.
Fabelhaft, mein Lieber, fabelhaft. It's your best friend this year.
So what role does the juxtaposition between food and violence play in shifting tone? In the most direct way, food becomes a literal weapon.
You want some coffee?
Yeah, sure.
He lulls his character and the audience into an enjoyable experience before shattering it with violence.
Very funny!
They might be savoring some white cake.
White cake.
Before all hell breaks loose. Or a celebratory margarita when a black mamba strikes. And these tonal shifts are a big part of Tarantino's playbook.
If I can pull off contradictory emotions, I want to play you as an audience. I want to be the conductor, and you're my orchestra.
Consider this shift we take in this scene.
There's a special rung in hell reserved for people who waste good scotch.
From scotch to slaughter.
See how feed us into your Nazi boss.
The pleasures brought by food destroyed by the pain brought by violence. Pumpkin's line says it all.
1 minute they're having a Denver omelette, next minute someone's sticking a gun in their face.
And Tarantino gets a lot of mileage out of this juxtaposition.
Everybody be cool, this is a robbery!
Now, let's look at some of the ways Tarantino maximizes this contrast.
You let him go! You let him go! Let go of him!
Tell us to be cool!
Be cool!
Be cool,
honey!
Be cool!
The food itself is indulgent. Hamburgers, shakes, nachos, pie. The list goes on and on. That's because when you combine indulgent food with extreme violence, you get maximum contrast.
That's why they call him Big Fred.
Going a step further, consider how Tarantino handles the presentation of the food.
I do like the fact that when you see my movies, you know, there might be one drink or one piece of food that the audience fixates on, and the movie actually makes them hungry for that.
A donut.
That's for me.
He does this in a couple of ways. The characters discuss the food.
I'm gonna order a big plate of blueberry pancakes with maple syrup.
They enjoy the food.
God damn, it's a pretty good milkshake.
They make the food. And how Tarantino shoots this is the topper.
Okay, and action.
Notice how the sound and close-ups capture the exquisiteness of Django's first beer. The strudel in Inglourious Basterds is a work of art.
I defy anyone to not want strudel when you see Inglourious Basterds. It doesn't mean, you know, it doesn't matter that just this Nazi guy's eating it. It's like, it's just, man, that strudel looks good.
Verdict.
Comme je disais, pas si mauvais.
The lighting makes this steaming, hearty stew the perfect meal to enjoy during a blizzard. He even writes this indulgence into his scripts. His description of stuntman Mike's nachos are just as excessive on the page as they are on the screen.
It was early, early one morning when I heard my bulldog bark. Was steadily in building lines, squabbling in the dark. Staggerly told building lines, what do you think of that?
In other words, Tarantino goes out of his way to make sure the food is as pleasurable as possible, making the inevitable violence that much more unpleasurable. All in all, Quentin Tarantino has found a multifaceted motif that works on a number of storytelling levels.
It's okay, honey. It's a friend of Terry's.
It builds character.
Promise yourself you're gonna stop drinking.
Relationships.
Woo-hoo!
And helps manage the tone surrounding violence in a way that no other filmmaker does.
Use your weight, boy! Use your weight, Dave! Come on now!
Linked below is our blog post on the complete guide to food in Tarantino movies. And if you're cooking up an idea for a script, start writing with Studio Binder's screenwriting software now. Who's hungry? What's your favorite food moment in a movie and why?
How's the pie?
So good.
Let us know in the comments. Remember to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon for notifications. Until next time, have an excellent day. Thanks for putting up with me.